Oh, Thank you. everybody. And was always getting into trouble. And one year we went with our girlfriends and our friend Misty to go to Las Vegas. We spent four nights there, which is just, yeah, it's a little long in Las Vegas. And the first three nights we took Molly every single night. And so by the fourth one, we were all a little bit tired and we decided that we would go to, I think it's called Belmont, which is not the strip. But if you guys have ever seen Vegas Vacation, where they go and it's like where the guys are doing like hiding their hands behind the back. So we're at this place called the Golden Nugget. Joe and I are getting very drunk, and they're serving Miller High Life inside of plastic footballs, and you drink them out of a straw. And Joe and I just continue to drink these throughout the night. He's punting them on the ground. Our girlfriends are getting extremely upset with us. We finally leave, Misty, our girlfriends, and I, and we're walking out of the bar, and a man accosts Joe's girlfriend, and he's too drunk to kind of come to her defense. And so I'm a little dude, but I grab this guy by the back of his, spin him around a few times and throw him into a kiosk that was not, but normally would have been selling novelty t-shirts. And we watched our girlfriends storm. Misty thought we were funnier than them, so she kept hanging out with us. And then we ran through the streets of Las Vegas, causing havoc. Joe was kicking mailboxes over, just ripping seven of them, and they surround us. And they immediately jump out and start screaming, and they separate me and Joe, and they're trying to get our stories. And I was pretty drunk, but Joe was like, could not fucking function, and his face is bleeding, and he has grass all over it. And they're like, what the fuck is wrong with you guys? And we're like, what are you talking about? And they're like, somebody just kept parking sign through the window. So we're freaking the fuck out, obviously. They've got us both over the top of cop cars like this, searching us and all these things. And our girlfriends are just, no. They're so upset. They're just watching from afar, like, you guys are going to jail, I don't fucking care. And then, thank God, Misty comes running around the corner a moment later. She comes into the parking lot and the police fucking tackle her. And they're on top of her and they're throwing her in cuffs. And they're like, we told you not to hook around here anymore. And Misty's on the ground like, what the fuck? And is screaming at these guys. And she's like, my dad's a fucking judge in Arizona, which was true. And the police are like, we told you not to be a prostitute, like moving around and blah, blah, and all this stuff. And Joe and I are just like, oh God, what is happening? We're like kind of flipping out. And then they finally, you know, things are sort of calming down. They've got us all in different parts and they've got Misty. First up, we have somebody who you may have seen before. You may know very well. Should have had you all right in order. Chloe, which one did you write under? You wrote a whole page. All of you did.
I did.
Okay. Well, first up, we have a wonderful, oh, she's here. She's arrived. Great. Here we go. Let's give it up for...
I'll just read my own introduction because you did a really shit job.
I agree.
Hello, everyone. Can you dim the lights? It's like, you know, I'm not 25 anymore. Thank you. Give me a little credit. Okay, Karan Devine has performed and exhibited works all over the US and internationally at MoMA, MoMA Pierce One, the Museum of the Moving Image, Documenta, the Museums of Sex in Amsterdam and Copenhagen, the Prada Storefront, the Storefront for Art and Architecture, Disneyland Paris, LACMA, the Box, the White Box, the Black Box, Circus of Dreams, BHQFU, the Met and the Metropolitan Opera, the Grand Canyon and the Sydney Opera House. But don't let that intimidate you! Karan is readily available.
Was wrapped up in clover. The night I looked at you, I found a dream that I could speak to. A dream that I can call my own. I the three.
So without further ado, new American, new thank you. But if you're here and you're hangry, I recommend the hanger steak. This salad bar is where it all began. If you're there from 5 to 7, don't miss out on their snap pee hour. They serve one wellness drinks. They also have a great health rating. They wash all of their vegetables in a 2-second. Okay, here's where it starts to get fairly xenophobic. International. I can't decide what was better, the panang curry or the drunken noodles. I'd say it's a tie. Their banh mi left me saying Viet nom nom nom. Nom 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 nom. Hard to beat this street meat. But the last time I noticed the health rating at the kebab cart. I have all the funniest jokes. I used to enjoy this Jewish deli, but they closed their doors and changed the locks. Aww. See, because they were put out of business. They were put out of business by a campaign. You see, their customers disagreed with their politics. The proprietors were not open to the possibility of 2-plate solution hummus. Which is really all too bad because the couscous is really good. What can I say? Boston Market serves some of the worst Turkish food I've ever tasted. Okay, here's a here's a review in the form of a poem. It's entitled "Say Ya to the Za." Dollar slice, I'm yours for life. Please take me to be your wife. Thank you. The arroz con pollo was so good, I wondered how Cuban trade with this country. It was so good, I said, Yuka, serve me a second portion. I think their frijoles negros are racist. Know how ropa vieja?
Ladies and gentlemen, Ari Richter. Next up, Victoria Ann Reese is very happy to be here. She loves BHQFU, double exclamation top of smiley face. This is her first time performing at a comedy night. She would like to thank Sean for the opportunity for everything else he's ever done, XOXO. Dear. Put your hands together or whatever for Victoria. This can be said like Notorious in the Big Show. Oh, like Victoria. Oh, that's what, okay.
How are we doing on time? Okay, before I start, I just have one simple request. And that's that you please don't laugh, because this isn't a comedy set. It's a performance art piece, and it's pretty serious. Actually, it's a racquetball game, but I think I might have some of the rules wrong. Spinning moms in the house. I don't know, if you haven't done it yet, just let me tell you, it's fucking amazing. Like, breastfeeding is so great. I would breastfeed anything. Like, on my list, like my top list, like my bucket list, is that by the time I die, I hope I have the chance to breastfeed one baby mammal from every mammal species. Especially wolves, like I really hope I'm able to breastfeed 2 twin baby wolves. Like as payback or thank you for Romulus and Remus. That's a Rome joke. But yeah, Yeah, so I did the math and I calculated that I've produced over 500 pounds of milk this year. My baby turns one on the 22nd. And I'm pretty proud of that. I think I might put it on my resume. Anybody hiring a milkmaid? So speaking of the torso, like staying on the torso topic, did you guys hear about Tig Notaro? Did like half of her set topless at the last like comedy fest or whatever? Did you guys hear about that? I thought that they say pain is beauty. Beauty is timeless, and time is a flat circle. So that's how time is doing on me and on all of you. And I love you guys, and thank you.
Thank you, Victoria. Next up, we have another special guest who also has taught here at the Bruce High Quality Foundation University. Let's give it up for Nosomi Rose.
Okay, there are departmental rubrics that I have to use for grading those main assignments.
Actually,
it's here.
Can I go?
There is a...
You have a whole file?
Yeah, no. No, this is just like, how it looks like. This is the rubric of number three. I mean, you can't really see it. But like, you know, I need to assign like letter grades for this creative, this is like assignment number three and the creative project. And like, excellent is A, good B, and needs improvement C, and acceptable D is F. And then like, when you look at what if improvement, or like maybe like unacceptable, like demonstrates no understanding of the context, purpose of guidelines of the art project, the project does not follow assignment, you know, guidelines, does not demonstrate individual creativity. I mean, like that, what does that mean?
We have a fresh young face. You're gonna love her. She has just come out with a book recently that some Canadian friends of mine were very excited about. What? G, are you in the house?
Yes, I'm here.
Giovanni Almost, everybody!
Clean up the world, our place, our planet, our responsibility. What goes in the ocean goes in you. Start today, save tomorrow. Clean up our climate. Choose alternative energy. Everything you throw away comes back. Plant for the planet. 30 days of green. Which future are you working for? Save the climate. Get your vehicle's pollution checked for free. Organic food, the soul of nature. Earth tipping point. Act now. Be green. Nature rocks. Let's go explore. Love Earth. Stop global warming. Want to use plastic again? Save the whales. Lose the blubber. Go vegetarian. Okay, I don't want to do this anymore.
Not all who wander are lost fans. Television joke. Good. Oh, are you ready to play that now? Okay. Oh, I forgot to say presentations. Yeah, you can flip that little guy open there. So, oh God, you did it so fast. Now I'm not ready. Which one is play on this? Somebody yell at me.
View.
View. Which one's view? You guys are getting so frustrated right now, aren't you? This one? Do I go down lower?
No,
it's at the top. Is it
present?
Present? Are you sure it's not slide?
Yes.
Okay, you can just click pretty fast. Click.
Snap and you want me to click.
Ha ha ha. Hey, hey. Ha ha. That's so funny. Ho, ho! Ho, ho. Lol. Lol. Lil, lol. Ha! LMFIO, laugh my fucking ass off. Hey. Yes! This is America. America, let's go. Should we fuck or do? You have something to say. America, yeah, yeah. Drink orange juice, dead man. We are okay. Yoga and steak. I'm fine. Be my teacher. Do you understand me? I understand you. The beginnings of visa. You, the beginnings of visa. Let's have sex in a Visa store. I was going to steal and give you AIDS. Well, what the fuck? I don't like you, hum yum sum. American, American, American.
Cue a round of applause, everybody. Sam Cook. I wrote this intro for Sam because he didn't want to wreck one.
Friendship is the best thing you can have. Friends won't just back down on you. Friends are always there. Middle school was sort of a blur, but what I do remember is having enough friends, and after having one friend for like all of elementary school, it was like she just left me and I had nothing. This all of a sudden sixth grade came and she just decided I wasn't cool enough for her, which was more painful than if she just moved. I went from the school I was going to go to the totally separate one. It's much smaller, much more focused, and I was able to make friends. There's a few of us. I don't really keep in touch with them as much, but I do text a couple of them every now and then. One of them is getting married tomorrow night.
I've been bipolar since fifth grade. Before that, people just kept telling me it was ADD from like second grade to fifth grade until they finally gave me a good thing of it's bipolar.
So I was trying out different medications. At the time, the one I was on where it was okay, but wasn't really good enough to keep me from just deciding I'm gonna sleep through.
Welcome to my performance. It's starting. I'm really excited to be here tonight. I'm extra super excited because my mom is actually here. My mom, her name is Lisa Brainerd, and her friend and my friend Amy are also here. I did a performance here. I told you guys that I was going through a breakup, and I was, and it's been about a month later since that time, and I'm doing better now. I think I seemed like I was doing fine back then, but I was really just kind of hiding some painful feelings. I don't know if you could tell or not, but I'm doing a lot better right now. So. Sort of excited to be back out there on the dating scene.
So last time I did a performance, I used the song, I'm gonna buy you a drink by I'll go surprise him. So it was not far from where I was. So I don't, for some reason I remember having balloons with me too. Just imagine for fun that I had like enormous pile of balloons behind me. So it was just like walking through the East Village like this in February. And I go to the Yaffa Cafe where he was a host at the time. Yeah, RIP. It's not, no, it's closing. It's closed?
Closed.
Sad. So yeah, he said he was working. So I go in there and I say, hey, is this guy here? I won't mention names, don't do that. And he wasn't. He wasn't there. So that was embarrassing. And that was my birthday in 2012. But you know what? Feeling a lot better now. So to show you how I feel about my romantic life, I'm gonna set the mood and do an interpretive dance. There will also be, last time there was some symbol, there was some symbolism. There's gonna be, you know, fewer symbols, but still some symbolism this time. So watch out. It's not as, but just keep your eyes peeled, okay? You know?
Give it up for Allison Brainerd again. And Allison Brainerd again because I fucked up her song. And give it up for Allison Brainerd's mom. And her mom's friend. Okay, great. We're going to take a 10-minute break so people can use the restroom, go outside, have a cigarette if you need to, or do whatever. We will. In 10 minutes promptly. Thank you. question is, which Mars Volta drummer are you and why? My business is taking chicks to the bone zone and we're going out of business. Okay, as we come back before our next performers, I would like to read a short list produced by myself and Rachel Hyman, aka Real Trap Horse, aka Trash Fuck Squadron, aka Come Through Girl. Holy shit, Laura Hughes, what are you doing here? All the way from Canada, eh? Sure, yeah. Welcome back then. Okay. Okay, a list of firsts for Baby by Sean J. Patrick Carney and Fabrega's Goofy List video. Baby's first immaterial art practice. Baby's first clout perk. Baby's first pair of relaxed fit chinos. Baby's first provocative juxtaposition of links. Baby's first found sound collage. Baby's first found poem. Baby's first frustrating semi-hard on MDMA. Baby's first surveillance. Baby's first time catching baby's girlfriend fucking her upstairs neighbor while the DVD menu like Peppy reference. Thank you. We have several more lovely acts this evening, the first of which, he gave me a little thing to introduce him, everybody. Okay, here we go. First up, we have Aaron Kuhn. He has been described as the least punctual artist of the 21st century. His body odor smells like Philly cheesesteaks, which totally works for the ladies, except vegetarian ladies, and any ladies who find his personality abrasive and his appearance unseemly. Also, he says, sounds like that one Macklemore song, you know the one? He just peed on himself a little bit. Ladies and gentlemen, Aaron Kuhn.
How's that for punctual?
Baby's first.
So I have to read a poem. I'm going to read a poem made out of the last 10 tweets I did. But right now I get like a couple text messages. One says, does anybody want at Aaron James Kuhn 8 hours ago? Bad hangover for pressure treated lumber to the fucking face. At Aaron James Kuhn 8 hours ago, cures number 5 ice cream sandwich, but the cookies are made of cat shit. Oh, Josh just retweeted one of them. At Aaron James Kuhn, he just favorited one too. Okay. At Aaron James Kuhn 8 hours ago, bad hangover cures number 6, sushi flavored soda. At Aaron James Kuhn 8 hours ago, bad hangover cures number 7, group texts. At Aaron James Kuhn 8 hours ago, bad hangover cures number 8, scotch on the rocks, but they're actually rocks. At Aaron James Kuhn 8 hours ago, bad hangover cures number 9, using asterisks to correct typos, but the typo was correct.
Now all 5 of us in here right now. How many? Do you know? I know you know exactly.
Yeah,
3?
But who's counting?
I was trying to, you know, be pleasant today, but 3. We all wanted to go there, because that curriculum, to be honest, sounds like where I want to be. Afrocentric? Hell fucking yeah! I've gone to art school for fucking 4 years. Never heard of some shit like that before. That shit sounded fucking amazing. A fucking utopia. You're telling me all the faculty is black? I'm there. All right, so I became disabled recently. Like, oh, am I gonna come out to Bruce tonight? Am I gonna hang out with y'all? And I first thought, I'm gonna come out so I can look brave. But I just need your pity. Like, just everyone, like, I'll be in the back tonight. Just everyone come up to me, like, how are you doing? Are you feeling good? I'll be like, oh, I don't feel so good. Buy me a drink, motherfucker. Thank you. side.
Well, then you don't know what happened. Zero. Sorry for your loss. Next up, we have another special friend, Lex Rocket. Unless you need to plug something in, is that correct?
Yeah,
let's go with... No, you can't plug in over there? How about right here? Look at this. Look at how many plugs are right here.
Hello. So, between the two. This is for all the sad comedians. You hate yourself and you want to die, but your depression is not a Kurt Cobain reference. He was not the first person sentence together, and you're not going to be the last. You go up to your father, you say, "Father." So you blush. You think your spirit animal is a stone. Ch-ch-ch-chia. You go to Paris and you hate it. Because it's not what the movies told you it would be. But then nothing is ever like the movies tell you it will be. Hacking is really fucking boring.
Not to talk about suicide. His dad's name is also Harry Tuman.
His cousin
leaned on a car and needed a co-signer, so
don't read it.
He leaned on a car so he didn't need a
co-signer. I realize my dad's in there, and I don't want to be a snitch, all right? So I'm not gonna say that intro. I have a new intro. I just came up with. Like last week, I went and I got an STD check at the free clinic, and the doctor brought me into his office, and he looked at me and he said, "No AIDS. Keep up the good work." That was it. Fucking awesome guy. It's all. I mean, that's my intro. So that's my intro. So I'm gonna do an impression. I don't really often do impressions, but I'm kind of nervous with it. But this is my impression of an old guy that goes to a party and he's out of touch, but he doesn't really realize he's out of touch. He's just trying to fit in with the party, all right? I'm gonna turn around and then it's gonna be the impression. So my mom is really worried about me because I'm a bit of a piece of shit. And she's like GMO. She's a GMO woman, you know, GMO or nothing, you know? And she tells me one thing, though. She's like, she tells me this one important fact. She's like, when you're peeing, just make sure that your pee is the color of lemonade. It has to be the color of lemonade, and that means you're healthy. And I'm like, Mom, it is the color of raspberry lemonade. You know what's crazy? Like, there's a lot of angry people in the city, right? Aren't people angry in the city? Like, they hold it in. You know why they hold it in? Because they don't have an anger shed. When I grew up, we had an anger shed. We had, like, a shed you can go, like, we used to play Street Fighter. And we'd play Street Fighter, and if my friend lost in Street Fighter, he would put holes in his wall in his parents' house. And then one day we just built an anger shed, and you can go out there and you can just go in the anger shed and you can break glass and shit. Because I saw like two cabbies fighting the other day. Like one of them, like they were just angry at each other, and one of them just called them like a gravy dick. He was like, yeah, you gravy dick, I'll beat your ass. Just like real angry. Like, I didn't deliver it angry, but he said it angrily. So I'm going home for the holidays, and I'm going home, and we have this competition. You guys, Dr. Oz is big. I don't think he's big anymore, but he was big in my family. with antioxidants. You guys, winter's coming. You gotta fucking pump up, guys. So my cousin, we all gather around, and my cousin has this antioxidant machine.
What?
And it tests your antioxidant level from like 10,000 to 50,000. And he tests everyone's. And he tested my uncle's, my Uncle Wayne. And my Uncle Wayne got 48,000 off the charts. And my uncle, and my cousin, my cousin Tony got 10,000. He got the worst. And everyone was going up to my Uncle Wayne like, he was the Jesus of the party, like, holy shit, 48,000, what are you doing? And he was like, carrot juice, that's all it is. Fucking kiggity carrot juice. And everyone's going around like praising Wayne. But I wanted to go to Tony. I want to hear the failure of the story. Who the hell wants to hear the party? I want to go over to Tony and be like, Tony, how did you get 10,000? He's like, well, listen to me right now. What I did every morning for the past, I go into my shower and I yard where I just smoke cigarettes.
I was confused because I was like, but fuck, I live here now. I had to get comfortable real quick, so just bear with me.
Chicago Bears, yeah, got it. That's a callback. That's called.
I can't be comfortable.
You don't know.
Okay. Oh God, I feel better, you know? Just because you have a partner doesn't mean we can't hang out later, you know? Do you guys ever feel like the circles in the deepest part of your personality? It's like all I have. Woo! Yeah! The best part of waking up is Folgers in your cup. That's an impression of a man. Like, I think I got rained on and just never dried out, you know? I don't know what's going on. It's a weird puberty. Cool. So, guys ever, like, make correlations between, like, people who call their pajamas lounge pants and like people who complain about airport Wi-Fi. Or like people who've Googled where's the beef. People who shop at Spencer's Gifts. Is that just me? people who self-identify as Satanists, you know, when they live off trust funds. I went to SVA, I'm a Satanist. Okay, you like Kenneth Anger, get over it. So sometimes, like, there's this thing where, like, I call something one thing and then other people call it something else. So, like, I'll be like, I'm decolonizing the snack experience. Jesus. And then they'll be like, why are you trying to climb inside that pizza? It's like, I'm not consuming, I'm like, okay. Like, somebody tells you they have sensitive skin, and then you're like, oh shit, like my skin's always secretly offending your skin.
Sorry.
Or like sometimes I'll hear dudes, none of you guys, don't worry, not all men. they'll be like, yeah, just like she was so crazy, like my girlfriend was so crazy. And I get really angry because I feel like it's like thinly veiled. And then I go home and I try to feel better and I just like start planning their Disney themed murder. Anyways, the joke was that I am crazy and I murder people. I'm gonna leave you on this. So one time I was on the street. And a cop rode up, and he was like, hey, do you know where the fight is? And I, like, had a really hard time not, like, just, like, pointing to his heart.
Oh, my God. Give it up for Brown again.
It was a snake to begin with. That's like that Freudian slip doesn't forward, but it's still the same joke. You know, like seriously, like let's take the fucking society that's the most neurotic about like deliberately causing people to die, like doctors, like and fucking you, like, cause you can have fucking brain tumor the size of a cuttlefish on some please kill me shit. And doctors would be like, oh no, because you know we won't do that because like this Greek motherfucker. right let's take their like deeply expensively like proprietary set and ask people who are like good enough at life, right? They were good enough at life to get a job where sometimes you like have to kill someone else. And be like, you guys do it. And wow. And you're like, YouTube? Talk to their accountant and they were like, let's move over to Italy, right? So they get to Italy and the EU obviously is going to like, because the EU made the fucking Turks get rid of the death penalty and they're still not fucking part of the EU. And there was a civil, not because of Turks, there was like an actual civil happening in Turkey and they were like, sure, to like buy your fucking, what are they, wine? Like, you're the MC to like trade freely in your continental market situation. We would be happy to get rid of the death penalty during our ongoing civil war. So you know, if an American, stay with me, if an American is gonna relocate to Italy, it's gonna be some shit like, this is how I'm American Chemical Corporation. It's like, yeah, no, I mean, that's okay. It wasn't really, like, ever that profitable, really. It's like, we just kind of did it, like, for the benefit of society. Okay, so, how do I start with... Well, first, I want to say that, like, as long as I'm allowed to be up here, that all the people being executed I'm talking about are going to be white people. So, if you laugh, like, you're not implicated in, like, expressing, except for the three of you, you're not implicated in expressing any kind of racial animosity. It's just, like, these are white people who got executed or are gonna be executed. What I'm talking about now is this guy in Ohio. And, I mean, we've all read the papers. This happened back in the 80s, but, like, you know, he's shot a stranger in the face for, like, no reason, so, like, fuck him. But the thing about it, and this is, like, I remember this from listening to stand-up comedy in the 90s, when they used to, like, the state of Oregon still hung people, there are all kinds of implications. I don't mean to, like, if you're fat in the audience, I don't mean to make you uncomfortable. I don't think this is New York, so there aren't a lot of fat people. Like, good job for coming out here. Nothing about this joke is intended to be at the expense of this attorney is being like, which... Okay, sorry, Sean. Aaron, which amendment is it? The cruel and unusual amendment?
Oh, 10.
It's number 6. It's the 6th amendment. Google it if you want. And says it's cruel and unusual punishment to, like, actually, like, this guy perform some kind of surgery on him. So, you know, like, actually, like, cut open his arm. Because the anesthetic is for when your, like, lungs collapse. It's not for when, like, some fucking, like, prison guard is, like, sawing into your arm. Like, who the fuck knows what the budget for, like, surgical quality scalpel fucking American prison in 2014
even is? Interpretation, though, James?
Well, it's a deeply subjective concept, one of the more deeply subjective concepts, but it's like, but he's not fucking getting, like, a Novocaine shot before they cut into his arm, so he's really worried. He's trying to, like, trim it down. Whatever.
Why are they performing surgery on a man who's dying?
Well, they've got to cut the fat. This is the process. They got to cut Sean. They got to cut through the fat in his arm. Because the length of the needle that they have is going to, like, keep them, like, from being able to actually transplant the... All right. So that's the deal. So anyway, the point is, they tried to, like, trim this on a fitness regimen. There's no...
Everybody give it up for Jim Brittingham. Okay, we're going to take a piss and smoke break, and then when we come back, we've got a few more acts. It's our last round, and I recommend that you stick around because they're all really funny, and I like them. Thank you.
I'm gonna go to the house.
Lorenzo, all of them people my kinfolk, at least I think so.
ever think that maybe photographers just hate that show the rest of the world how fucking easy it is to take a picture of something? I want to Sublime slash Richie Havens cover band called Lou Dog Diamond Phillips. If Catholic school taught me anything, it's that priests have two jobs. One priest, two tickle monster. There's no crying in baseball, but the last time that I checked, my shower was in baseball, so I guess I'm doing okay. What's the difference between manic depression slash suicide ideation and a DVD box set of the Matrix trilogy?
What?
I'm not in possession of any Matrix DVDs. What idiot called it American Horror Story and not United States Spooky Narrative? If Bieber is racist, then how do I have my MFA? Are goths the people who buy the lighters? Oh great. Here comes Snowden on his ivory fucking Obamacare horse, slut shaming Jared from Subway and passing out dinner rolls like it's fucking Boxing Day. Whenever I go invisible on GChat, I feel like such a slutty bitch. So, if Hillary gets elected in 2016, will they still call it the White House? Comedian's joke. His name is Max Wittert. Max Wittert, Max... Did you seriously do that? You just wrote your name like 15 times.
Yeah.
Okay. Max Wittert, Max Wittert, Max Wittert, Max Wittert, Max Wittert, Max Wittert, period. Max Wittert, Max Wittert, Max Wittert, Max Wittert, Max Wittert, period. His name crossed out. Yeah! Give it up for Max Wittert!
Hey guys, I'm Banksy. Max.
Can we show up on the first one? You want this to be a slideshow?
It's just messed up, like, crazy.
What do you want?
You can just do the art one.
Art. Do you want me to change it? You just snap at me?
What? Oh, no, I'll do it.
You can do it.
I mean, yeah.
Well, they're changing. Oh, shit. Going back.
Okay. So. Okay.
The last button.
We're all familiar with this famous quotation. Oh, she's like completely inbred. From far away, she's a Jackson. Yeah, she's a Jackson Pollock. From far away, she's like completely confusing and overwhelming. But I mean, she's mostly about the process anyway. She's a total Kandinsky. From far away, she seems fun, but like up close, there's just not a lot going on. She's a total Renoir.
Apple.
get more blonde is by adding more hair. I'm so blonde, I took a shower and the water got purified. What's a very skinny sulfur is suicide. You don't even know how messy my bun is right now. I sat on a butterfly and now I have a tramp stamp. Total slut for avocados. I'm also a regular slut too. The most important meal of the day is whichever one I'm able to skip. In my entire life, but I live in Williamsburg.
Give it up again for Max. Next up, we have one of our features, one of my favorite people, one of the tiniest people I've ever met. I'm a tiny man, and I have her intro. Anna Fabrega. She's very funny, I know. She's probably gonna kick my fucking microphone stand over again. Our next performer is from the martial arts studio downstairs.
I recently turned down an offer to be a cast member on Snull. On Snull, because I wanted to be taken seriously as a performer. Now, live from New York, it's stand-up comedy. I was on the subway when I was a kid, growing up. Did you guys read about, there was an article, did you hear about the new study? A buddy of mine, did you guys ever think about, sorry, I'm blanking. I brought these in case that happened. But I forgot to write my jokes on them! Ah! I'm so embarrassed that I used to be a baby! You know, I wonder, I can't help but wonder how old I'll be in 5 years. Does anyone know what time Payless Shoes opens on weekends? People need to stop writing books. There are just way too many out there. Yeah, hi, I'm at the movie theater. Turns out they stopped playing 4 years ago. I do not sleep in jeans. Can I get a cordless mic now? I want to do a bit where I jump out of the window head first into moving traffic. Hey, you guys mind if I sit with you? My name is Justin, but with a CH. I just moved here. I moved here from a different city. You guys should come over sometime. My stepdad can teach us how to slam dunk a perfect spiral right out of the park. Water bottles are the perfect combination of water and plastic. My name is Sam, but everyone calls me Samantha for long. Are there any PTA meetings next week? Any good PTA meetings? Look at me. I care about you so hard. Life is full of moments. It is a series of events, and everyone reaches a point in their life. I'm coming to you live from the red carpet here at the VA. Who will win best music? Find out.
Stay tuned.
My school spirit. I'm trying to raise awareness. Did you know 1 in 5 people represent 20% of the population? Every single week, there are 7 days. And dying is the leading cause of death. I'd be lying if I wasn't telling the truth. If we work together, we can make a difference. I'm so angry. I'm not getting everything I deserve. This is an impression of me on a date. So, didn't you know they eat raw fish in Japan? I entered a contest. I really hope I win. I was in Times Square and I hailed a cab. I get in, lo and behold, it's the cash cab. I said, you know what? I don't have time for this. I got out and I walked to the M&M store.
Whoa! You just saw me do that! You just saw me. Don't drink with your mouth, you fucking copycat! That's my thing! That's my thing!
My lucky number is 7, and I eat at Chinese restaurants for the sentence cookies. Sorry to be doing this up here, but I need to change my wallpaper right now to Baby Tasmanian. I love comedy, and that's no joke. You know how they say that the more you learn, the more you realize you know? I'm not so sure about that.
Coach! How can you bench me with only 7 left on the clock? I could win this for us. I put my heart and soul into sports.
Before I start my set, I want to take a little bit of time to talk about the future of journalism. Look at what I find earlier. It's dangerous candy. It's a lollipop with a scorpion in it. Earlier, I see a girl eat an entire banana and it was red. And I was like, what the heck is going on? And then I wanted to jump, but I couldn't because my shoes was too heavy. I was in a splashdown at 0 for more than 20 minutes before they found me. I go to Baskin Robbins and they had the camouflage ice cream for the Veterans Day and I really wanted to get one, but I couldn't because I was scared that I wouldn't be able to seize it. I'm learning how to swim with my arms and my legs. I was listening to Hit Clips, the same song, over and over and over, and I never once get bored. I know how to make easy raisin salad. It's just raisins. I can't help but wonder why attractive people don't like me. I'm here. Did you guys hear? Kiki is back. Whoa, there sure are a lot of options.
Fuck. So many choices.
What's in the grand salad? Well, funny you ask. The grand salad has lettuce, bit of a tongue twister, cherry tomatoes, cucumbers, black olives, pitted, may I add, a thinly sliced red onion, and plenty of feta crumbles. And of course, your choice of ranch dressing or ranch vinaigrette. Hi, I'd like to rent a computer. I saw a flyer with a dog on it that said, have you seen this dog? And all I could think was, well, I have now. So what if the climate is changing? We all change. That's part of growing up. Does anybody know any good promo codes? I want to get at least 20% off my next order. As you can tell by looking at me, I grew up within walking distance of several factories. Any single people here tonight? Anybody single?
Sure.
Yeah. I just got out of a 3-year Disney cruise. And it sucks, because the answer may
surprise me. My family and I always wear bootcut jeans and white t-shirts. We're often photographed barefoot. This is an impression of me at Topshop. Yeah, hi, trying to get the look. Here for the look, please. Did you guys hear about the alligators? Turns out they're real. What do you need to surf? You need waves, you need a surfboard, you need balance, you need a wetsuit, and you need Beats by Dre. You guys, I'm talking about music. I'm talking iTunes, Shazam, SoundCloud, Spotify, Groove Shark. Who here still buys encyclopedias? I own over 300 issues of Highlights magazine. My favorite TV show is Survivor. Does anybody have a Zoom charger? I want to listen to music on my commute home and my battery's almost dead. Any Zoom chargers? Nobody. Anyone here from Hillside Academy? Any wasps in the house from Hillside Academy? Okay, whatever. I guess I'll just whistle for 30 minutes. What does he eat all winter? I know the question on everyone's mind is the incident I'm not allowed to wear bandanas anymore. What's the secret to tomato ketchup? Watch out, Mario Batali. I'm here she comes. Let's see. We've got my sisters, my brother, my parents, my grandparents, my aunts, my uncles, my cousins. Heck, that's my entire family. I love listening to music on my laptop speakers. I strongly disagree with someone that doesn't have the same opinions as me. We are sad to announce that the showboat is closing. Thank you for 23 memorable years. What's a candle without wax? It's just a string. I was at Grand Lux Cafe and I had an epiphany. I should wear more diamonds. Me? Two things real quick before I sit down. I just really...
So, like, Sean's class is, like, the easiest class I've ever taken.
Never gone.
All you have to do is, like, skim an email and not show up. I wish this was karaoke. I get distracted a lot without someone telling me what to do. I wish I was hosting this.
Me too.
Thank you. I hate anyone who is paying attention to their phone instead of me. And you like get your socks. And then you like check your phone. And then you're like socks or like toe socks. So you one sock, one toe, two toe, three toe, tweet, four toe, five toe, six toe, eat, JK. Seven toe, eight toe, nine toe. When I buy toe socks. We don't have endless time. This is where it gets serious. Yet there's an endless stream, an endless feed, endless media. But it's like fucking I meant expression. Spend a lot of time at home these days. Maybe you can tell. Thank you.
We have Nicole Rever. We're going to take a small break while we set up the tech for it. So have a pee. BRB. I didn't mean that to rhyme.
This is a joke.
Oh, you're like huge. Oh, wait. Even if you're no,
Thank you.
baby's first reveal of subconscious racism. Baby's first parkour phase. Baby's first Facebook post critiquing the writing on Thought Catalog. Baby's first art about entropy. Baby's first cable. Baby's first straight edge phase. Baby's first proselytizing about psilocybin mushrooms being a spiritual trip. Baby's first bae. Baby's first shade. Baby's first Uber ride. Baby's first screen capture. Baby's first ASMR video. Baby's first rhododendron at home. Baby's first alkaline trio tattoo.
Dated.
Baby's first problematizing. Baby's first awkward
Nicole Reaver. Are you running from the... Oh, you're here. Nicole Reaver doesn't normally do crowds, but she will tonight. Yo, am I right?
Woo!
The fuck does that say? There are no letters at the end of that.
That's so. Woo!
Wait. Okay. Are you still turned up here?
Yeah.
Do you need audio on this thing?
Sure, I sure do.
Oh, great.
Cool.
Oh, fucking
great. Oh, alright, here, hold on. Okay. Good. Sounds like the parking lot of ditched
in high
school. You'll see it in a second.
Wait, but is it
on the... No, I have to Google it.
Oh, you're gonna...
It's part of it.
Oh, wonderful.
Yeah.
How
did you guys
all... You're gonna take us through a walk through the internet.
Yeah. Have you ever heard of that? How did you guys all find out about this party? The internet. So we're all on the same page. Cool, I don't have to walk you through this. Okay, so it's been like a really intense week on the internet. I don't know if you were there, but I was.
Rider Gate.
That's not what I'm talking about, but relevant. Okay, so I know what kind of crowd I'm working with. You're all informed. So I learned this week that the internet loves to fight about women's bodies, guys. I learned that. And so I was like totally. Alright, so you guys trying to get the point. I still don't get it. I've been watching this one. Couple times, kind of like, I didn't get her point when she sent me the link. So, kind of, I did a little bit more Googling. You know, gosh, there's all these stats. It's your life, man. Let's see. So, I went on this website, Song Meanings. I don't know if you guys can remember this one. And I figured that I needed to go to who I go for all my information, which is like other people just kind of like trolling. That's where I get my best news. And I was gonna see what other people had to say about this song and kind of tell me what I need to know about being a woman. They know so much. Cool. All right. So this is what I learned because it's my birthday. You guys can be so critical, and most of you act like you know her personally. Yeah, I think not. Just from what you hear on TV, yeah, then I guess you must know her, right? Maybe she is being herself, maybe she isn't. Focus on the music and what the song means. Isn't this site songmeanings.net? Huh? Yeah, I thought so. I just thought I'd throw the other crap in there to tell you guys. So I think this song is what she really feels, and she wants to start over and create a new image of herself. I think it's great. She's successful, and most of you typing on here are not.
Nice.
So, I mean, like, you can have an opinion. cough. Man, there were so many opinions on here. It was a lot to read. You know, I really just didn't know what kind of girl I'm in the world. You know, it's like, am I Kim K? Am I Christina? It's still really confusing to me. This guy, I thought was pretty insightful. Though Lil Mama 69 came up with a valid point. I would have respected her more because they were influenced by the deep and real interpretations of the amazing Christina. So worried for his friends. I really have an issue with the video though. I feel like she wasn't able to express what she was truly trying to because of censored material. If Skinamax played music videos, then she would probably have been able to express her true artistic message. Anywho, I think that the meaning is deep. Deeper than you do. I think she references a biblical text by a clever satire of Mary Magdalene. Get it up. Yep. You can just put your butt to the maximum. Uh-oh, here we go. That's my favorite, Christina, you rule yourself. And the thing about that comment that I thought was kind of important is I didn't understand what anyone else was saying about like feminism and women's rights until I got to this one, and I only got it because I went to Catholic school and there was a lot of butt stuff on the deal. Thanks.
I'm too tired to explain the situation. The hotel room, and it's kind of like, oh, the airport joke, the hotel joke, like, no one cares, it just happened, and they fucked up. So I was given, like, as compensation, I was given this amazing suite with, like, this kind of amazing, like, floor to ceiling, wrong direction, marbling. And I got in the bathtub and turned myself into a raisinette, and then they brought wine and my door, so that was beautiful. But the bed was kind of bullshit, and I couldn't fall asleep because of the pillows, and I was drinking a divorced mom amount of wine and eating peanuts from a cereal bowl, reading an email from a beloved friend former, who might be in the audience right now. And yeah, I can't believe that you guys can do this on a daily basis. I don't know how, because I'm dying. And so she was encouraging me to write down like stories and jokes that I was going to tell. And the joke that I thought up of, which if you want me to tell it, I'll tell it to you after the video, which you can like close your eyes during, fall asleep in, like it's not a visual thing, it's totally cool, don't worry. So I told one of my best friends this joke that I'd come up with that I'm so proud of at Wetherspoons, which is like such a fucking piece of shit, like despair just like hole in the ground, and they totally viable, so yeah, fuck that. So I wanted to do this on Halloween because I wanted to kind of like explore the theme of fear because I'm always afraid. Fear. Fear, like my fear of suicidal pilots being like, fuck it! And then just driving the plane to the ground or whatever. And I don't know, like after Air Malaysia happened, that kind of was.
Where's the plane?
No! Where's the fucking plane? I don't know. If I knew, I'd tell you. But it's. So I just kind of. No, but it's a real thing. Before I ever get on a flight, I always look at the pilot and I'm just like, would you belong in a grainy, shitty photo on the cover of the New York Times? And if he doesn't, then I get on the plane. I've missed flights before because of this. In real life, I've been like, no. And just told my parents like, oh, I was in the bathroom putting on lipstick and then I got it duty free and I forgot and then I didn't get on the plane. So that was real.
Fear. Like public transportation terror plots. I got a text the other day saying, "Don't go Subway." Getting like some weird reactions, so I don't know. If that's So no, I'm not sure if like using the word bitch, like it hurts like bitch, is okay. No, because that's like a strong thing. Like women are strong, but like I don't understand that because I'm like a 1920s housewife, and I'd be like a really great sub, and I'm just like, yes, sir, master. Oh my God, don't hurt me. Like authority, confrontation, judgment, shame, embarrassment, anything involving putting yourself out there, which is what everybody's been telling me to do recently. And my preferred environment is on the second floor of a jewelry store, making jewelry, and then if something goes wrong, you blame the salesperson. So that's not putting yourself out there. Fear. Like what I'm doing now. I'm so scared. I feel my hands. Are you thirsty? Would you like to drink from the moisture? So instead of telling you about all this, all right, so this is a true story. I have a friend from college dating a guy named Rich Husband, like as in Richard. Richard Husband, and I'm sure like Richard Husband is a common enough name, but if I found myself a Richard Husband, I'm sure he'd be a dick. Hey! Yay! Here's my video!
Alright, here's Pink's video, which is really good. You guys ready?
Yeah.
Are you?
I said, are you guys ready? Donka.
No, I'm not.
With you everywhere I go, but it don't seem like you know. I sang your praise like an old songbird, but remember you're my baby when they give you my. And just to show that I care, I will write and declare, though you're on the loose, you are still on the square. I'll be lonely, but even though I'm lonely, there'll be no one. But send that rainbow to me, and my shadow will fly. And though I'm gone for a while.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Pinky Ghoul! Let's give it up. We got Lindsay Leonard, one more, while we wait for her. I would like to talk about
Obama.
Barack Obama.
No.
He's really nice, it seems like, right? He seems really nice, but then there's the, wait, what are you doing?
I just need to put up,
Oh, a new video then.
Yeah.
Oh, got it. Are you afraid of the flyaways? Oh, great. The coolest thing about Lindsay Leonard is that her name has two syllables that are
about
got me off. I was like, oh my god. I didn't even know. It was like, they are so cool. They are just cool. Another one is like Pink and what's that? The guy who was in Black Sabbath, his daughter. Kelly Osbourne. The other night, my friend, like Kelly Osbourne, came up to him at a club and with Fergie and was like, touch her boobs. And he was like, oh god, Fergie, oh. Anyway, so this is hot. Hot girls, attractive men and women, the thinner you are, the sexier you are, the more money you have, the better you are as a person, just to remind you. So I'm gonna turn this down a little bit. Turn down for what? Anyway, I hate everyone that left. I have such opening act like anxiety. I would rather be an opening act. Just relax, everybody, just shut up. So, oh wait, it should probably be like this. So, Lena Dunham, Frumpy Awareness. It's so cool that incredibly well-educated, incredibly well-connected woman can represent other frumpy-ass bitches. It's so cool that someone with everything can have everything. Can we talk about salts, like sucking the guy from American Apparel's dick? I mean, not every person can be an to dudes on dudes porn. Let's talk about that shit. Because that is so weird.
You make all this money, get this far, no, I'm a business woman, man. I'm not concerned. Better on the seas before you in the turn. Back in the days, I would have been smashed. You getting money now. Bitches in the hood.
Yeah.
Stop paying these niggas to write y'all shit. For the right cream,
I like a lot of really bad thoughts.
Better be careful what you say to me.
When I get really upset,
I'ma make you snitch.
One of the biggest issues I've always had for my whole life is when I'm upset, I think really bad thoughts. And I thought that that made me a bad person. And I usually do a lot of things that were bad or something. So I'm just gonna share with you one of my bad thoughts. So, rich people holocaust. Take all the rich people, just kill them. Torture them. Fuck out of them. Hang them up like a deer. And stuff. Your other living relatives. On a super air conditioned film set where nobody has a cardigan. Thank you.
Okay, everybody, let's maybe give it up for Lindsay once again. Okay. And then can we all just dance? Maybe? Yeah.